Russ is a cool dude. He's definitely in that fucking cycle of being overrated and underrated and overrated. We understand that. But when it comes to playing with LeBron and AD, none of it makes sense. You thought the Giannis wall was crazy? These motherfuckers about to have a Lakers dungeon, my nigga. These niggas are going to set a fucking boxing one on the paint. A 25 point per game all-star capable of making the playoffs and guarding 1-5. Y'all tell me if I'm the asshole for saying he's not prime Kawhi Leonard. If the Nets are like the Avengers, nigga, hey, Nige, we're kids next door at best. We ain't even the Teen Titans, bruh. What kind of fake-ass super team is this? It's nothing convincing me that this is a good move, necessarily. I'm being so serious. It look like we fucked again. I don't hate Russ. I'm just pissed off.
You suck.
Me and my niggas, you know we got that. They say, why you too hype, bitch? I feel like I'm amped up.
Sage is gonna be okay. I'll smack the piss out of you, boy. Look, let me explain something about this dumbass trade, bro. Let me explain something about this bitch-ass trade, chat. Look, I get it. The Brody stands may not get it. The motherfucking Bron fans may not get it. Hell, my fan base may not get it. This trade got like a 15% chance of being great and a 70% chance of being painfully bad. And the remaining, what is that, 15-10 of being mid as fuck. Let me explain. I'm gonna be so serious. I'm being as honest as I can with y'all today, chat. I swear to God, today was gonna be a video on Kyle Kuzma. It was just gonna be me talking about how nobody wants Kuzma, how this is a situation that should be like tough as fuck. It's like, okay, nobody wants the guy because he's old as shit. He's the young scorer that don't get no buckets. I swear to God, chat. It was supposed to be a good day. Today was a good day, head ass. I ain't had to use the AK, you feel me? Like, it was supposed to be a good fucking day. And then you tell me somebody wants Kuzma, and for a split second, I'm like, oh, yeah, cool. Then you realize that's Cab. They didn't want Kuz for real, but we'll get to that in a minute. You're telling me, chat, that the Los Angeles Lakers woke up today and gave up their pick, Montrezl Harrell, KCP, for Russell Westbrook. Now, that trade's not bad. I know what some of you guys are thinking. Russell Westbrook is clearly the best player. I understand exactly where your dumbass mind is, but listen here, bitch. This is the fucking problem. This is legitimately a trend for Russell Westbrook. 2009, 2010, he shoots above 40. Next year, shoots below. 2011, 12, he shoots above 40. Above 40, above 40. Good for you. Too bad he then goes on a streak of below 40. Below 40, below 40. This nigga is in field goal percentage Elo Hill. He literally cannot go several stretches shooting above 40%. This nigga is food. This dude's gonna turn the ball over, dribble the ball off his foot, throw some dumbass pass out of bounds, but he'll get a rebound. There's only two legitimate reasons as to why this trade could work, and this is why I said 15%. One of my biggest issues with the Lakers, consistently, this LeBron James bitching for a foul after he gets fouled 20 seconds ago. There are certain players this season, LeBron doesn't play two defensive possessions because he thought he got a foul 2 plays ago, let alone did that spread to Anthony Davis to a degree, let alone did that spread to motherfucking Markieff Morse. It was a thing going on in the Lakers culture. The ref is my nindo, my ninja way. These niggas refuse to play basketball if the ref didn't make the right call for them niggas. Russell Westbrook is going to be the one player who I know he won't do that. Russell Westbrook is going to be the person that doesn't cheat us on a night-to-night basis. Maybe that will inspire other players to play harder. Maybe we play better as a team overall because we're playing harder. Not to mention, Russell Westbrook is an all-star level talent. They could possibly figure this shit out. I just think it's a bare minimum of how they figure that shit out. Shout out Lo. I was in Lo's stream. Lo had a really short stream today, and he talked about how this trade's pretty fucking stupid. He wanted Buddy Hield really bad, and the Lakers could potentially run a lineup that has the worst spacing in the league. You are dead wrong. You think Frank Vogel's going to start Marc Gasol over Andre Drummond? Oh my God. Frank Vogel's gonna have the genius idea to say, you know what? Let's run Russell Westbrook, Talen Horton-Tucker, LeBron James, Anthony Davis, and Andre Drummond. We can't shoot. Can't shoot. We cannot fucking shoot. You thought the Giannis wall was crazy? These motherfuckers about to have a Lakers dungeon, my nigga. These niggas are going to set a fucking boxing one on the paint. You ever see a team want a boxing one on the paint? That's all they gotta do to stop the Lakers. Want a boxing one on the paint.
Shit is
wild, bro. There's one factor that I forgot to mention in this trade that I suppose is just a straight up positive. No matter how annoyed I am at this shit, there is one positive thing about this trade. Man, get this nigga the fuck up on out of here, dog. Get that nigga the fuck up on out of here, dog. I'm not praying for his downfall, but I believe he's fucking stupid. Here's my issue with Kyle Kuzma. This notion that Kyle Kuzma could actually be the player that he believes he is insane. For those of you that don't know, the player that Kyle Kuzma believes he is, a 25 point per game all-star capable of making the playoffs and guarding 1-5. My biggest thing is I just want to play with a consistent role. If I have that ability, I'll be able to showcase what I can really do. Okay, Goten. When I'm in a consistent space, I'm out there handling the ball, making teammates better. Y'all tell me if I'm the asshole for saying he's not prime Kawhi Leonard. Y'all tell me if I'm hating for saying he's not prime LeBron James, to say he's not clearly better than Paul George. This shit is ridiculous, chat. Goodbye. Good riddance. Will not be missed. You're not gonna be that guy at Washington. This is the final thing about Kuz before I get back to Russ. Niggas that say he can, they act like Kuz is young. He's 26 years old. How much taller, faster, stronger do you expect Kyle Kuzma to become? The only thing that's really gonna improve is IQ, maybe the jump shot, maybe defensive intangibles. But he is literally in his prime. Russ is a cool dude. He's definitely in that fucking cycle of being overrated and underrated and overrated. We understand that. But when it comes to playing with LeBron and AD, none of it makes sense. It just does not make sense. We're trying to win a championship. This dude is religiously a first round exit. And if he's not a first round exit, he's some shit in the second round. In the last 5 playoff runs, he's played a combined 29 games. And look at these stats, man. Oh my God. I swear this wasn't on purpose. 25 points, 8.6 assists on 4.7 turnovers, giving you 9.7 rebounds. That's fine, but he shoots 6 threes a night and doesn't even make 30%. He shoots 22 shots a night and doesn't even make 9 of them. He has a true shooting percentage of 48. It's the same player that y'all be on tip about, bro. It's nothing convincing me that this is a good move necessarily. I'm being so serious. It looked like we fucked again. There's going to be possessions, chat, where Russell Westbrook's going to drive down the lane and pass up on a wide open AD and or LeBron to dunk the ball himself. There's going to be possessions, chat, where LeBron James is on the break. Russell Westbrook's the only player that can match his speed. Hell, he surpasses it. And LeBron's going to kick it out to a full sprint Russell Westbrook, who is open at the three-point line. We know that jump shot's going to go up, and we know that jump shot's not going to fall.
We just got to stack the deck, you know what I mean? We just need another all-star, you know what I mean?
This is the unstoppable super team. If the Nets are like the Avengers, nigga, hey, Naiji, we're kids next door at best. We ain't even the Teen Titans, bruh. What kind of fake-ass super team is this? You got Mr. Backbone connected to the neck bone connected to the shoulder bone connected to the ankle bone. We got this bad back built-ass nigga. Then you got Papa Russell Rolling Stones, and I got Rolling Stones under the... Got this old ass name. And then you got the Crayon Eaters champion. Y'all want to call this shit a super team. You got teams like a prime LeBron James, a prime Dwayne Wade, and a prime Chris Bosh out here. This is the super team that we want to run with. Niggas don't even think Russ is that good. Nah, LeBron still got it. Hold on, first of all, you know what's wild? You know what's really wild about saying LeBron still got it? You know what's wild about that statement? The Big Three Miami Heat were formed in 2010. 2011.
Niggas better be 2022.
And we're acting like the man does not age.
We're acting like the man is literally the same person, if not a better variant, than he was damn near 12 years ago. Dog, I swear to God, he has a wife. He got a wife, bro. He good. He's not gonna fuck you, bro. Like, there is no need to lie right now.
So you got that narrative spreading that this is a super team and LeBron can do it now, yada, yada, yada. Even though he's aged 12 years older, he's clearly not the same person. And some people even leave him out of the top
top fives altogether. But yes, somehow this is the super duper team that's gonna make it to the finals. I got to see how this works to believe it. Defensively, I almost say we took a downgrade altogether. But I don't think anybody that we traded is fantastic on defense any fucking way. Offensively, I'm literally scared. But that's just the whole narrative. We'll let niggas have that for a different day. This one is one I'm starting to see more and more on the TL. I don't know why. I don't know how. I need to start on following niggas.
Giannis did it. The Bucks did it. The Bucks did it. They didn't have the best spacing. The Bucks did it. Fuck it, the Lakers. The Bucks can do it.
The American education has failed a lot of you niggas, and it's just sad. Listen here, bitch. This is the problem, bro. The Bucks play defense. The Bucks can shoot, and they play defense. I don't even know if this narrative that the Bucks ain't shooting, like, where did that come from? Like, I don't know what stat they're using. Like, is it in the finals they didn't shoot that well? But okay, cool. They're religiously a shooting team. I don't know why people are trying to push this narrative that now you don't need spacing because you want to protect your Brody. Shut up. Because you'll be the main next time up. Steph Curry's gravity. But when it comes to LeBron, AD, and Russ, man, spacing overrated, man. You can put in chips without that shit. Yeah, okay. I don't hate Russ. I'm just pissed off. There's a chance in hell that it works. Game recognized game. Russ realizes his flaws. He won't just become a magical 35-40% shooter from three. Get that out of your fucking head. But he finds a way to make his play style work with LeBron James and Anthony Davis. And they go far because despite the lack of fit, those are three great players. There's a chance that happens. I've argued that for a team like the Nets, where it seems like it's three niggas who are just doing the same thing at different heights. I ain't been at the level where it's a player that looked like he is the bipolar opposite fit for both. For him to be clearly our third option, our third most valuable player, clearly, and he already has the resume of being an underperformer in the playoffs, that's a problem. And if you can't recognize that at bare minimum being a problem, five of 11 trips, he shot under 40%. Move that up to 42, and that is majority of his runs. Move it up to 43, that is all but two runs. And move it up to 45, the only competent playoff run he would have is his 2009-10 run. The players we traded, I don't give a fuck about. I'm not breaking sweat, losing sleep at the loss of Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. By the way, Joey Taylor, I don't know how you in my searches, but that's a woman. I ain't gonna lie, Kane do it. I ain't gonna lie, Kane do it. I'ma fuck with y'all niggas. I'ma post this on YouTube. I'ma hit it up.
W streams.
Live. Ain't Young Venom. Yeah, I got the cannon. If a nigga talk too much, I gotta blame him. I wonder where the hate come from. Gotta be a dumb dumb undercover someone. You want on my chair drunk? Is it the paper, the moolah, the haters, the rumors, the leaked news of me and your shorty in Kama Sutra? I might just shoot you. Guns blazing, my little Ruger. It's not a blooper. In the Honda, I just maneuver.